Vyakti as your profession. Be proud. I tell you, after 5 years of time, you will call me and tell me that, sir, you told us that, yes, we are proud. And after 5 years of your practice, you'll tell me, yes, we are the chosen ones by God, the Almighty, and we are doing best things in our life. Why? When we give a antipyretic remedy, drug in allopathy, fever comes down, no doubt of it. They are ultimate, they are top, they are best, no doubt of it. But when we give a homeopathic medicine and when the fever comes down, nothing like it. The feeling within yourself will be so beautiful. So this is why I'm trying to tell you, be a homeopath. What is the quality of a homeopathic doctor? The passion to learn more, the eagerness, the curiosities, the inquisitiveness, the doubts coming in your mind. This is very, very important when you go about homeopathy. When you think about learning about homeopathy, there must be hundreds of doubts, hundreds of queries. And the more the queries, the more you are progressing. The more it is getting confused, believe me, more better, more progress. Okay? So this is a vast science, ultimate science. And I believe homeopathy as my religion, my passion, my God, everything, because I have, you know, that immense faith in my system, immense faith in my pathy, that I can do anything in my life. I can do any because of homeopathy. Such love, trust. I won't utter trust. I would utter the word faith. Of course, in homeopathy and amongst ourselves. This sentence I always start with every webinar, seminars. Why? Without faith, you cannot start your journey. You cannot start your journey without faith. And the most important is having faith in your own self as a homeopath. I will do it. I can do it. I must do it. This time, for a change, I have not bought any bad pathological cases, because last 3 to 4 months I'm just showing you all bad pathologies treated with homeopathy. But in college, when we talk about college, the student should, you know, be that motivated to practice homeopathy. And I'm really gratitude to the principal of this college, the vice principal and everyone, that you are taking so much pains to enhance the confidence and passion in homeopathy to all your students. I'm really very thankful to you. Now, once you are into this homeopathy college, let us start the journey of homeopathy. First, why I have selected pediatrics as a topic. We cannot explain homeopathy within 1.5 hours or 2 hours. No. But definitely we can show you a path towards homeopathy, how to understand homeopathy, what is called as the behavioral materia medica. Hahnemann sir has said in your Organons of Medicines, mind is the key to man. But what is this mind all about? Kent sir has said, one strong mental general can rule out many, many physical generals. So I wanted to suggest that the pattern, the nature is very important. Anna? So how to understand the behavioral materia medica? What is behavioral materia medica? It consists of constitution of the child, of the person, the behavior. Now, for example, I would say Bachchan, Amitabh Bachchan. Amitabh Bachchan, how will you understand Amitabh Bachchan? I mean, Amitabh Bachchan will be understood by tall, lean, thin, you know, a very smart, handsome guy, a beard, a French beard, glasses, black glasses, and those are called as the keynote symptoms of the person, of that remedy. Okay. But what is the essence of Amitabh Bachchan? Just listening to that, just understanding you come to the conclusion that this is Mr. Bachchan. When he says, "Hey, sala, malum tere ko hai, hey, sala, hai." The voice, this voice of Amitabh Bachchan is so peculiar. The voice of Amitabh Bachchan is so queer. This voice of Amitabh Bachchan, the style, "Hey, sala, hey, tere ko malum, hai, hey." This peculiarity, just a minute, this queer, rare, strange symptom what Hanuman sir has told us years together back. PQRS, let us try to understand this PQRS of some remedies. We cannot tell you every remedy at once. Stretch at 1 hour or 1-2 hours. It's very important. It's difficult. It's not difficult. It's impossible. Dawn ko pakadna munkil nahi. Kya? Na munkil hai. Hai na? So, or Rajnikant, that style, yeah, rascala. So these are the keynotes, the essence. And I'll try to tell you the essence of some remedies. So once you understand this essence, then What may be the physicals, that should also match at the same time. But the essence will not go. Essence should be there for every remedy. Amitabh Bachchan, if at all, give you the dialogue of romance. Ki, of konsa dialogue hai uska? I hope you see Hindi movies. Woh gana hai, "Main aur meri tanhai aksar ye baatein karti hai." Same voice. Huh? Similarly, Amitabh Bachchan, "Rishte mein toh hum tumhare baap hote hai, main shahenshah." Same voice, symptoms different, voice same. Okay, "Hey, sala, malum tere ko kone apun, Vijay Dinana Chawan." Symptoms different, voice is the same. The essence will always remain the same. And I will try to tell you the essence of some remedies with context to pediatric chair. What is a pediatric age groups? First of all, let us understand, what is pediatrics, child? See, and why I have chosen, just see the students, my dear students, remember one thing. If you can treat your child, I tell you, not your child, sorry, I take my words back, sorry. If you can treat a child, the whole family will become your patient. So business-wise also, if you try to understand child, you will be the most successful practitioner at your area. Why? Because there is so many kids suffering from asthma, cough and all whatnot. And they are unable to get cured because of the right medicine. If you cure one case, believe me, if you cure one case, you will get hundreds of cases of the same diseases. Okay, so I have given a focus to a child. Child is very, very interesting. I am doing the research in congenital anomalies of a child. What is this? That I will, later on I'll tell you how to come. But how to understand a child? What is a child? Who is a child? You know who is a child? Yeah, good morning, Sudhakar. Who is a child? A child is the one who has no responsibilities, who don't carry any responsibilities, who doesn't bother about the consequences. A two-year-old child, now this is how we understand. But one-year-old child, usko potty aaya and he couldn't see any place. The child will pass urine then and there. Isn't it so? Hello. The child will pass the urine then and there. Isn't it? So this is normal. The child is the physiological child is the one who doesn't bound about the boundaries. Usko boundary nahi hai. This child has no, what will the society talk about me, what he will think about me, what she will talk about me. Is it like the child is like child freedom? So here I tell everyone, if you will give freedom to your child, whatever he wanted to do, let him do. If at all he will do, let him do whatever he wants. Believe me, and if you give that freedom, the child won't fall sick. Don't do this, don't do that. Freeze, don't open the freeze. Don't switch on the AC. Don't eat ice creams. Don't eat grapes. Don't eat banana. Banana is the enemy of all doctors. Don't eat banana. Once you eat banana, you'll fall sick. Come on. Don't feed those things. Yes, agreed. If at all he's allergic to banana, don't yell at him. Hey, don't eat it. If at all I'm eating banana, I like banana. If I'm eating, and if at all your father or mother yells at you, hey, bloody, don't eat. What will you feel? Have I eaten poison? Immediately the reactions in the body start. Sore throat, cough starts. So what I wanted to tell you is, you need to understand what is a child. What is a healthy child? The one who doesn't like to study. Very good. Not students. Hello. Not students. Students should study. Okay. I'm talking about small child. Okay. Don't want to study. Doesn't want to eat homemade food stuff. Who wants to eat bahar ka khana, restaurant ka food, pizzas, burgers. They love it. Okay. But Cadbury, chocolates, Maggie. Okay. So these are normal. There are so many patients who come to me and say, Doctor, my child is not healthy. You know why? He always demands a burger. He always demands, he's not ready to study. He's not ready to, you know, get up early in the morning. You get up early in the morning. Who likes there? Come on. Who likes? Nobody likes nowadays. Till 12:30, you are not sleeping and you expect your child to get up 6 o'clock in the morning. Oh, how is it possible? So you need to understand what is the deviated state. What I had said to peculiar, queer, rare, strange. Now the interesting story starts. Okay, a person comes, a child, 6 years old child comes to you. Right, as soon as he gets into the chamber. All right. Yeah, and says, good morning, doctor. This is something abnormal. That means he has been burdened by the parents. Say good morning. Join your hands. Sit down properly. Hello, doctor. How are you, doctor? Hi. So a 4 or 5 year old child greeting me, standing, sitting in front of me, even in a very erect position like this. Hello, doctor. How are you? Hi. This is something abnormal. A child should come and like this. Had it been a case of fever, it's a different story. All right. Had it been a state of, this is normal. Fully 102 degrees Fahrenheit temperature suffering from fever. 3 years old child. Now I'll be starting giving tips to you guys. Take down the pen and paper. Whenever there is a child suffering from fever, okay, and if at all he's doing it, and the parents will tell you that whenever he gets fever, he just goes on moaning like this. And this morning should be continuous. Again, write it down on your paper. This morning should be continuous. It should not like so now in these two mornings there was a break, isn't it? So if there is no break between the morning means this. This is called moaning, M-O-A-N-I-N-G, moaning. See, I'm trying to make you know, just moan. But every breath, whether it may be a 6 months old child, whether it may be a 6 year old child, or whether it may be a 79 year old child, if at all he's doing, and whatever may be the disease, बट इफ आई टोल्ड दिस इज प्रोमिनेंट आई एम टेलिंग यू इसेंस अमिताभ बच्चन का वॉइस इफ if this is prominent write it down the remedy is belladonna the remedy is belladonna and the rubric is write it down morning every breath with manish shall I share my screen
yes sir you can share sir
okay now I'll show you the rubric it is so beautiful Hello, can you see the
it's visible sir
so simple morning with every breath belladonna and the inputs have been done by Chitkara doctor and Dr. Phatak and they are really very very authentic okay so they are the we call them hamare bade bade saab hai sab bade bade boss log these are the bosses of homeopathy Phatak sir and Chitkara and all Coins are everyone. So see how beautiful it. Now, if at all we take some, see, and in 7 months old child or a 2 year old child, how will you understand? How will the child say the symptoms? Isn't it so simple? So isn't it so difficult? Sorry, isn't it so difficult? How will you share? How will you tell? See, the 2 year child. If you'll ask, what are you suffering? From the child how will the child tell you the child will say he'll look at his father then the father will tell he's suffering from this then he's so bad it's okay but you need to understand the exact depth with physical exam hence medicine is equally important when hence clinical knowledge is equally important but at the same time if the child is belladonna now I will give the key now this is I am talking about the behavioral matter of medica of belladonna just write it down the child who is very playful in spite of fever he will be playing with anything either playing in mobile stamp field whatever but this child has that energy still he has a fever of 102 degrees Fahrenheit still the child is playful and he doesn't require any specific thing to play he can play with even the dupatta of the mother with a hanky of his father whatever but he start playing ow think of belladonna I'm not telling you the rule but actually think because can you imagine a patient a child suffering from 102 degrees Fahrenheit eyes are watering and still he's playing belladonna we have a rubric playful you can see belladonna so when don't take the rubric playful when the child is already consumed antipyretic and the fever is already gone and now in the clinic he is playful don't take the rubric playful then it will be a big disaster when should you take playful in spite of the fever which is 102 degrees Fahrenheit and still the child is playing belladonna this playful child yo and still what still that when he sleeps belladonna okay so this morning is very important the way the morning is the delicate morning oh my as if you want as if you just hold the child and just take and just start caressing him. Oh no beta oh you this is how the remedy changes now this morning just listen to me very carefully there is a morning with a sense of pity means what that delicacy you know pulsatilla See, Pulsitilla, you know Pulsitilla, how you know Pulsitilla? Pulsitilla, you know, a very blue-eyed, blonde, you know, very cutest, delicate. But the morning changes. Instead of, hey, Sala, malum, tere go. The tone becomes, hello, hello. So Amitabh Bachchan is ruled out. Now someone else is coming. So this is how we talk about behavioral materiality. So Pulsitilla child will start mourning in a very beautiful and a very piteous way. So the cuteness will, you know, reflect on the child. Is it? So no matter what symptoms she is suffering from, it is not like no matter. Yes, it always matters. But to say the way she is mourning is very important equally. The way she asked the mother. You know, this mourning becomes very interesting for the Pulsitilla child. Then the mother holds it so and just start caressing. Once she started, it just goes into the arms of the mother and just sleeps. This is something which is you need to understand in a child. So I'll start with the PPT, okay? And then come to know how to understand what are the behavioral patterns of a child. How does different kids behave in a different manner when you start taking a case of a child? It may be a chronic, it may be a chronic case, or it may be a, you know, acute case. It may be a case of thyroid. Child suffering from 6 years, 7 years age, suffering from thyroids, a child suffering from whatever. But the understanding, the case taking is very important. And that is the art, what sir has already said. The art of case taking is really very interesting. Okay. So let me. With PowerPoint, yes. Now let us see the am I this PPT is visible?
Not yet, sir. Only the repertory presentation is visible. PowerPoint is not visible, sir. I think you need to stop the sharing and you need to restart the sharing, sir.
Acha, sir. Okay. Now?
Not yet, sir. Only the radar part is visible, sir.
Okay, just a minute.
Yes.
Now?
I think, yes, sir. Now it's visible.
Now, is it visible? Okay. Now this is pediatric case taking. Okay. I just half an hour, I just introduced you how we understand a child. Just giving some glimpses. I'll be only giving some glimpses of all kids, but there will be some one interesting rubric at the end of our last half an hour. I'll be taking a rubric, how to understand a rubric, which is mostly in front of you every time in your clinics when the child suffers from any acute disease that I'll take later on. But let's understand how to understand a child, okay? See, many women, okay. In a pediatric case, apart from the what, how, and why. Now, I would not like to focus upon what, how, and why. What means what? What does the patient say? How does the patient say? And why does the patient say? This is what about the totality, okay? But see, observe the child in the clinic. His gestures, mannerisms, tone, I told now, the mourning of tone of Pulsitilla. And how was Belladonna on the morning? Okay. Gather information from parents. For example, sometimes what happens is you need to understand if a child is suffering from fever. And if a child is suffering from fever, and I tell you, how can I bring back my video again. Hello.
Yes, sir.
How can I bring back my video?
You need to, sir, your video is visible, sir.
No, but I wanted to show the expressions on the screen.
Sir, for that, I think you need to stop the sharing, sir.
Stop the?
You stop screen sharing, sir.
Okay. So I should, because... Achha, am I easily visible?
Yes, sir, you are visible, sir.
Okay, then I'll tell you.
Yes.
What is the purpose of gathering information from parents? Okay, this is what I wanted to focus upon. See, what happens is when a child is suffering from fever for last 5-6 days, if the child is suffering from fever and the fever is not getting down, if the fear is not getting subside, then what is to be seen? See the chemistry of the parents, whether the parents are gelling well together, the mother and the father. Because what happens is there are some sensitive kids who fall sick just by their small argument between the father and the mother. Look into the chemistry of the father and the mother, because during narrating of the symptoms, sometimes the father yells at the mother, shut up, I'm telling you, shut up, you just keep quiet, I'm telling you the symptoms. So this puts a big impact on the child when there is a quarrel between the father and the mother. So this may be one of the, so you ask the parents, had you been in a good terms for last so many days, or you have a big fight and after that this child has fallen sick? If the parents say yes, the doctor, that may be one of the possibility. That day we had a big fight with my wife. I had a big fight with my wife, and that time he was crying like anything, and next day he got fever. So you need to understand the sensitivity of the child is very high. Then this child is, since that day, doctor, I'm telling you. So students, write it down. Since that day, after that fight, since that day, he has lost the charm on his face. He's like this. Now this eyes, I'll tell you, the gestures in a child, the most important part of the gesture in a child is eyes. Grief is seen in the eyes, love is seen in the eyes, anger, hatred, domination. If a father is dominating, that fear of the father is reflected on the eyes. If the child is very curious, getting my point. So this is how we understand and interpret a child. We have a rubric curious in our repertory. We have a rubric inquisitive in our repertory. We have rubrics. We have so many unexplored rubrics in the mind section of the material repertory. And we are here to tell you every rubric. We are wanted to share our experiences. Okay, so this is one of the beautiful. So this, what was that remedy? This child like this. Doctor, since that quarrel, he's not eating well. He's not sleeping well. He's not laughing. He's not crying. He's not shrieking. Nothing. He's just like this. Look into my eyes, my dear friends. I'll stop sharing the screen. So I will be here. Now imagine a child of 4 years, 3 years, who was full of charm, who was full of vivacity, who was full of energy, who was full of cheer, everything. And one big quarrel of the husband and the wife, or the parents, mom and dad quarreled badly, and this is ignitia. Write it down. Elements from discord between the parents. Number one rubric. And number two rubric is disconcerted. What did the parents said? Earlier he was like this. Yo, playful, chubby, cheerful, vivacious, dancing, affectionate, caring. alert every moment. Mommy's come. Mama, you want water? Papa, yeah, you. And a big quarrel. And the harmony of the house was disrupted. And immediate effect was there on his. The child face started crying. No, please don't fight, Mama. Mama, Mama, Papa, don't fight. Still, the parents were going on fighting. And then this child loses his, you know, hope and just lands in a state of disconcert. It means now nothing can be done. This is Ignatia. This is Ignatia. The eyes of the child. The child is in front. I can't show because of some privacy issues. Otherwise, when I show and come in seminars, I show them a case of pneumonia. Easily, just looking into the eyes, the disconcerted eyes. Ignatia, silent grief. Write it down, Ignatia. Disconcerted ailments from discord between parents and silent grief. Ignatia wants harmony. Anna? Okay, so this is how we understand. So this is what I wanted to focus upon. Again, I wanted to share the screen now. Manish, can I share the screen so I would go into the yes. PPT?
Yes, sir, you can share, sir.
So how share screen. Okay. So now this again we'll go to the PPT. So I wanted to focus on what is to be, you know, just for this is information from parents and attendants. Now this is the point number two. Everyone read the point number two very clearly. His gestures, mannerism, tone, expression. I would like to tell you again. I stop the scene. I enact. So it would be more interesting, right? It would be more interesting. So stop sharing. So I will come in on the screen. Sometime I really wonder how could I become a doctor? I wanted to be an actor, I suppose. Yeah. Sorry. So now I tell you how the behavior patterns. Now a person of a child suffering from high fever, high grade fever, 104, 105 degrees Celsius fever. And the child is brought in front of me. Now, see the tone, see the gesture, everything. The child is like this. 4 years old child, okay? 4 years old child suffering from fever. Temperature is 104. Now, temperature 104 degrees Fahrenheit. Now, 104 degrees Fahrenheit is a high temperature. So obviously the reaction should be how? The reaction should be whatever. Isn't it so? Or moaning, there must be some symptom. But in now, my dear students, pen and paper, note down. 104 degrees Fahrenheit, patient suffering child, 4 years old. So high temperature, and the child is like. When you look into the face, onto the face of the child, you will feel as if there is no reaction. It's all right, like this. What's your name? Mayur. What is the race? 4 years. Kya ho raha hai? What are your symptoms? This is no symptoms. Huh? So. The physician gets astonished. Oh my God. Are? In spite of 104 degrees Fahrenheit, he has no fever. He has no symptoms because the pain bearing capacity of opium is very high. Okay. Again, I want to tell you the core, the essence of this every remedy. So opium's, what is opium? Pain bearing capacity. Very high. So, yes, Premlata, you are absolutely right. Well, says he went very, very sick. In spite of sickness, the rubric is well, says he is well, went very, very sick. This is how we understand opium. This is the behavioral materiometric of opium. In spite of opium child, if at all he's admitted in the hospital, okay. What happens first in hospital, we take out the blood reports. when we pierce the need into the arms of the opium child is like this. What is the normal reaction? This is the normal reaction. And how is opium? This is peculiar, queer, rare strangeness of a remedy. The behavioral materia medica of the remedy. The core, the essence, the center, the epicenter of a remedy. Painlessness of opium. Yes, Premlata, right? So this is how we understand a child. Okay, now let us go some. Now I would like to tell you something about, for example, phosphorus patients. Phosphorus. Huh? Note it down. Students, note it down. No doubt phosphorus, that thirst, craving for lemons, agreed. But the essence, the core. See the eyes again. Eyes rolling here and there. When the phosphorus changes the doctor, child, obviously the child never changes the doctor, the parents changes the doctor. When the patient is not getting better in one clinic, the parents get the child and gets him into the another clinic. Isn't it so? Yeah. So the child doctor is changed. So he said, who is this doctor? In clinic, there is no table in between. In my clinic, there is no table in between. I sit and exactly there is no table in between and there is a sofa in front of them. And just like we talk and enjoy life in our clinics. So the child was in front of, he said, first observation. Papa, there is no table in between. See the observation. Child, phosphorus is a very good observer. Curious. Phosphorus is the child who will not get afraid of the physician every time. They will be just watching her. Where am I? Achha, this is a new clinic. Papa, new clinic, new doctor. Achha, okay. When I ask the child about his information, this phosphorus child will always, you know, talk in a very, you know, extroverted manner. Hi, doctor. Yeah, doctor. Uncle, there is no table in between. How, you don't put it. When do you write the prescription? Oh, okay. See, he starts gelling with the physician very easily. The phosphorus, what is the keynote of phosphorus? To gel with anyone, any given person, he can gel along very well. If a phosphorus 6-year-old child or a 3-year-old child is traveling in a railway and it's a long journey of around 10 to 12 hours. If phosphorus child is sitting in this plus, on this sofa, this phosphorus child will see to it that he will be that friendly to everyone in the compartment. Hi auntie, hi grandma, hi mama, hi papa, hi mama ji, papa ji, kaka ji. He can do anything and gel along well with everyone, even the physician. I would definitely would have liked to show you a case of a child, say 4 months child. Child I had treated, he was suffering from severe diarrhea and the diarrhea was so intense that this diarrhea, the whole, you have a rubric in phosphorus, is the same term as if the diarrhea, as if anus is wide open, profuse diarrhea, agreed, no doubt, but the eyes were so interesting. 3 months child, baby, but in that eyes, there was that curiosity, but there was no fear, mind you. There was no fear, you know, like this. I'll come to a same next patient. Now, the phosphorus, what is the essence? Gel. Why? Gel. I cannot explain the whole journey. If I start talking about phosphorus, 1 month will be not enough to talk about phosphorus. So many rubrics to explain. But what is the essence? The Amitabh Bachchan voice. of phosphorus is gelling. Gelling is that the essence of phosphorus, isn't it? Very interesting. Hello. So we have a rubric. We have a rubric. Alert of every movement of. Alert every movement of the physician. We have a rubric. You wanted to see that rubric? Okay, I'll tell you a rubric later on. Now one more child who also rotates his eyes here and there like this. Okay, note it down, students, note it down. The one who rotates the eyes here and there just like this, but with fear. Write it down. Phosphorus rotates with curiosity, without fear. With fear. Dr. Nikita, very good. Iosiamus. Now look into my eyes. Students, look into my eyes. Focus upon them very clearly. All right? Write your understanding and you'll never miss for Iosiamus. In your clinics, because I tell you, ISM is the most common cases. Belladonna, ISMS, every case, most common. What is the core of ISMS? Now he is also rotating his eyeballs here and there. Right? ISMS is fear plus doubt plus curious. He always feels insecure, unsafe in the society. He feels anybody will come and just grab him away. So if at all I offer a chocolate to a hyosomous child, hyosomous will just look into this chocolate as if the CBI officer inquires about the thief. How does he inquire? Tell me. Then. Similarly, Hyosemus inquires, which is the chocolate? Is it a real chocolate, or within that chocolate there is a hidden medicine? Now, these gestures are very important. Again, eyes. The eyes are rotating here and there, but there is fear. Hyosemus. Eyes rotating here and there, looking here and there, without fear. Phosphorus. We have rubrics. Okay. So, curious plus fear of being injured. Plus, write it down, the rubric, fear, betrayed of being. What is betrayed? Backstabbing. Backstabbing. Bahubali Shaha. Bahubali. Picture, na? Bahubali. There is a picture by now. Bahubali. It's a picture. Usme. कटप्पा क्या करते हैं बाहुबली को कैसा मारते हैं हेलो बाहुबली ऐसा होता है पीछे से नाउ दिस इज बैकस्टैबिंग किसको किया बैकस्टैबिंग बाहुबली को किया तो हाइसेमस ऑलवेज कैरीज दैट फियर ऑफ बीइंग बिट्रेड गॉट इट सो ऑब्वियसली द आईज विल बी विथ फियर एंड out. If mother offers him warm water also, he'll look into the water. What is it? Okay. Then only it will drink. Otherwise, he won't. Hai na? So, Bahubali's backstabness is betrayed. This is the fear of Hyosemus continuously carrying through. Hai na? So, this is how we have to understand homeopathy. Isn't it so? So, just a minute. I just again come to this PPTs. I don't want to miss anything. See this hyoscyamus, belladonna, lachesis. These are some I want. One more. Observe the child's reaction to the stimulus in the environment. How does he behave or relate to the physician, the staff in the clinic, attendants, or any other clinic reacts to torch, stethoscope, toys? I'll tell you how. A sulfur child, my dear friends, note it down. Note it down. Sulfur child. Again, sulfur is also in the rubric curious. Oh, acha. Okay. This is very important. Observe the child's reaction to the stimulus. I got a very good insight in this para. How does he behave or relate to the physician, the staff in the clinic? I'll tell you. Staff. Okay. I just talked about phosphorus, na? There is a child, 3-4 year old child of phosphorus, and my receptionist is outside. There is a big rush in my clinic, and this phosphorus child has made that gatti with this receptionist. Now, can you imagine a 4-year-old child making that, you know, that gelling with the receptionist, so she can jump into the queue? And so instead of waiting for 1 or 2 long hours, what this child does? Josna, please, I will come. Let me go inside now. Josna, please. 4 year child. And this Josna, my receptionist, is obliged to that love caressing of that phosphorus child, and she allows her to go inside. The receptionist, this attendant, I told you this is how clever phosphorus is also. And phosphorus again, that gelling. Got it, a gel. Bhai chara, brotherhood sensational. Okay. Now, sulfur child. Students, again, note it down. Sulfur child is also like this, rotating here and there. Very curious. But sulfur, this sulfur child is very philosophical. We have seen, philosophical. Kya word hai toh? Philosophical. Okay. What is that rubric? What is the word of sulfur? Ragged philosopher. Isn't it so? Ragged philosopher means what? The sulfur child is really very philosophical. This sulfur child is a very intelligent child. We can talk with a physician for hours together with in-depth understanding. I'll tell you one case of sulfur. You understand, you just imagine how we perceive a child, how we understand a child. He was looking here and there, and there was a big poster of Gautam Buddha as a meditation. So looking at that portrait, everybody feels blissful. So that has been placed in a waiting room. So what happens is, when the patient sits, how many of my kids have asked that, why have you put that Gautam Buddha ji's picture on the wall? He's the one who will ask. Curious sulfur. Acha, it is meditation. Okay. Acha, sir, you also do meditation? He was asking me. Well, yes, I also do meditation. Also, I wanted to know what is meditation. See, curious about knowledge, sulfur. Now he was sitting in front of me. All right. I understand. Now, sulfurs, what is the main crux of sulfur? I also tell you. Sir, so child was in front of me and said, yeah, better. How can I help you? What is your problem? The child said so beautifully, actually, I'm suffering from worms. And because of that worms, I'm, you know, passing loose stools. So just in order to make the child comfortable, I have a big jar of chocolates. This time I won't tell you the jar chocolates theory. I keep a big jar of chocolates in my clinic and I put this full jar of chocolates in front of the child. And with the reaction, I come to a conclusion that this child is very timid. Why timid? Because only one chocolate. Sometimes grabs with both hands. Sometimes he looks into the face, onto the face of the parents. May I take? So very obedient, dominating child. So he gets many insights when you offer a big jar of chocolates in front of the child. So similarly, I put a big jar of chocolates in front of the child. And what happened was really interesting. When I placed the big jar of chocolate in front of him, what was his reaction? Very, very interesting. He just looked into the, What did he say? I have enough. Self. Write it down. I have enough. So that it don't matter. You have enough. You take it. Take one of, this is a falado. It won't harm your stomach. Come on. It's a fruity. It's a chocolate made up of fruit, of strawberry. It's a pure chocolate. It doesn't have any, you know, ingredients which will harm your stomach. He said, no, doctor. I won't take it. Why? What did she say? You know, it was so beautiful, she said. The boy said. See, basically, doctor, if I'll eat the chocolate is sweet. And if I'll eat sweet chocolate, then it will go into my intestine. And once I eat sweet chocolate, the worms inside my intestine will eat that chocolate and become more stronger than my intestine. And once they become more stronger than my intestine, then I will again fall sick. So I'm not eating chocolates. I was like, oh my God, what is this going on? This 4-5-year-old man, what is he trying to teach me? He's trying to teach a doctor. Oh my God. See the philosophy. See the theory. We have a rubric theorizing. We have a rubric philosophy ability for. We have a rubric curious again. And the most important rubric, I have many, plenty of them. What is that? That is, we have a rubric delusion, wealth imagination. It means I have plenty of chocolates at my home. Okay, at the same time. And when he said, I don't want to eat chocolate because the chocolate will go inside. It is sweet, the worms will become more stronger and they will again harm me. Okay, so the mother was really surprised to listen this story. The mother was like, huh? And the sulfur child was, does he really do this? I asked his mother. In last slide, what was there? What was the given in the last slide? It was written clearly. Confirm with the attendees or the parents or the guardians. I asked the guardians, is it like this that he really doesn't eat chocolate in spite of having so much chocolates in his refrigerator? She said, no, doctor, what? He's just lying, doctor. Yesterday only night he ate 3-5-star chocolates. The child was like, This is what you call as, means what? He was presenting himself so good in front of the doctor. Isn't it so? I'm this, I'm that, I'm like this, I don't want. And yesterday night he ate 2-5 stars. That was something. That was, if you have a rubric. Hypocrisy. HYPOCRISY. Hypocrisy is showing that you are a different good man and from within you are something different. This is how we understand homeopathy. This is called as the behavioral materia medica. Isn't it so interesting, my dear friends? So this is how we sometimes, you know, get to know the essence, the cure, the epicenter of a remedy. I would like to share you a small case of a just an infant suffering from jaundice. The bilirubin was 27. And I got a phone call, just a phone call. It was too far from my this. So I took a telephonic consulting and she said, "Doctor, I'm in real trouble. My child is just 11 days old and this jaundice is 20 to 27 bilirubin." And now exactly can't recollect the exact units, but it was very pathological, more than 20, the bilirubin level. And the patient was on the, in the incubator and all possible treatments were given and the child was not responding to the treatments. I asked the parent, I wanted to speak with the mother. I just saw this video of the child and the child was like 11 days child, you know. And the mother was speaking, "Alo bachcha, ajo bajo bajo bachcha, ajo bolo bachcha," and the eyes were responding at the same time. So interesting, man. It's so interesting. At the hum log Hindi mein bolte hain, Marathi mein bhi bolte hain ki iski aankhein kitni baatein karti hai. A child's eyes are, abhi, I cannot say, English is a language which puts up so much barriers to give the exact feel. Ke bolke, hum log Marathi mein, we call in Marathi, bolke, yane, baat karne wali aankhe, the eyes are so communicative. We have a rubric, communicative. Sulfur child. No, Ashlesha, I'm again talking about sulfur only. The eyes were so charming and, you know, communicative with the mother. It was very interesting. And at the same time, I asked her, what went wrong? What went wrong? The mother said so beautifully, mother said, actually, as soon as the child was born, students, please hear it very carefully. As soon as the child was born, she was a newly born mother, right? So the child was born and the mother was having an experience of only one day. So mother was not ready to bear the pain of the delivery, post-delivery pains. And she wanted to sleep for some time. Now, this is very interesting. And the child was on the cradle. And the child started crying. Quack, 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 quack. Suggesting that the child wants milk, the mother's milk. What happened was, this mother ignored the crying of the child. And she somehow ignored the child and I'm really tired. My back is paining badly. The stitches are paining so badly. I just wanted to take a break. So the grandmother, which was sitting beside, told her, you know, at least give her breastfeeding for at least 2 minutes. Getting irritated, this mother got a bit irritated. Hey, drink. She bared the breast to the child in a very, you know, harsh manner. The mother said, "Doctor, to my surprise, the child just turned away her lips and didn't touch my breast." And this was what? Can you tell me? Can anyone tell me what is this all about? From Kittu, yes. Very good. This is this is ego. And we say that we cannot understand a child for at least 5 years. We can understand a child at the age of one single day also. Egotism plus curious plus charming others. His eyes, the physician, the pediatric physician who was attending the child said, in spite of the fact that his bilirubin is at so high levels, he's so cute, he's so charming, He's so communicative. He's so active. This everything compels to give him sulfur. And within 3 days of time, he was discharged. If you want, I can show you the case, but I cannot show you right now here. But it was a fact. And we can, every homeopath, single homeopath can cure such types of cases. How? Just to by understanding the eyes, the gestures, the atmosphere of the home, that what we call as IPR. My guru, my master, Dr. Milind Rao, had taught us the IPR, interperson relationship with the child and the environment. How is their father? Is he very protective, very dominating, very strict, very lenient, over pampered, spoiled? The child may be spoiled also. You want chocolate? Take. How many? 10 chocolates. You get, you eat 10 chocolates together. And then the teeth starts decaying. So these are all things which matter. And these are the things we need to understand. These are the things we need to focus upon. Of course, you can take physical symptoms. I'm not against physical symptoms. But this basic information is absolutely important. Basic information of the child, the case taking is really very important. Isn't it so? So this is how we understand the child. Now, Manish, I would like to take a rubric.
Yes, sir.
See, we have the most common rubric. क्यों नहीं हो रहा, नीचे क्यों नहीं आ रहे? हाँ, दिस इज अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग रूब्रिक. हेलो, आई एम ऑडिबल ना?
यस सर, यू आर ऑडिबल सर.
सर, दिस इज अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग रूब्रिक. वंस आई फिनिश ऑफ विद दिस रूब्रिक, द वेबिनार विल बी ऑफ. टिल देन आई डोंट नो हाउ मच टाइम आई हैव, बट I would try to, finish off this rubric, okay, which is called as a bread and butter rubric. And the rubric is carried desires to be carried constantly in complete repertory. Okay. What is this carried desires to be carried constantly all about? Whenever there is a child, the child is suffering from any problem, most of the times, the child is being carried by either the mother or the father or the guardian or the attendant. Okay. But there is a chance. Now, this is again, students, note it down, write it down. There is a chance that the mother says, doctor, since his fever, what is she doing? The child is only asking me to carry constantly. Bus. Nothing else. She's just going on asking me to carry me. Bus. Nothing doing. Just carry me. Bus. That's all. That far and no further. So this is the adaptation of the child during sickness. So this adaptation needs to be considered. Okay. So we come to this only 5 remedies: arsenic, chamomilla, senna, kalikarp, sanicula. I hope everybody is able to see this PowerPoint.
Yes, it's visible, sir.
So arsenic, chamomilla, Chamomilla, Senna, Kalikarp and Sanicula. These are the rubrics. These are the remedies which ask the parents to carry them constantly for us together. Isn't it so interesting? Only 5. In the Materia Medica, we have so many remedies, but only 5 of the remedies ask their parents to carry them constantly. So how will you differentiate? Hai na? So let us move to the next slide. Now this is very interesting. Okay. Okay. So guys, please note out the rubrics. Carried desires to be carried constantly, plus quieted cannot be carried only by being rapidly and smiling. Noted down the rubrics. The best thing is you just take a snapshot, because I'll be telling you about arsenic. Okay. Now, arsenic child is also very common in the clinics. I tell you a small case. Fever, last 4 days, the fever is not subsided at all. And the mother came to my clinic like this. This is mother, not the child. This is the child. Okay. And this is the mother. The mother was totally devastated. Doctor, please do something for this child. This child's fever is not getting down. Somehow it is not getting down. Please do something. The hair, the dress up was in a mess. The mother's dress up was in a mess. And the child was like smiling. The child was smiling. Okay. This is very interesting. So I really wondered whether the patient is a child or the patient is a mother. So I said, why are you so weak? Why so you very mentally weak? So physically weak? Why are you so fatigued? Why are you so, devastated? Why are you so crumbled? And your child is smiling. She said, no, doctor, this is what I wanted to tell you. This child has literally killed me. What? Can you imagine last 3 nights I'm carrying her? Last means what? The whole night I'm carrying this child. So the child falls asleep. So what I do is, I place the child on the bed. Once I place the child on the bed, again. This story is since last 72 hours. Now imagine, all listeners, all viewers, imagine. This child is asking the mother to carry constantly, no doubt of it. Okay. But what will be the consequence of this 3 days continuously carrying the child? The child is so irritating the mother. Oh, please. This child I had to carry. See the halat. See the way the mother is suffering. She said, doctor, if I'll keep the child down, she will start. She starts crying like this again. Give such medicine that she will sleep properly. She will have a good sleep. She will have her fever goes off. She will eat something. Please, doctor. Now, this is a very interesting rubric. Okay. But, so when I carry the child, students again note it down. When I carry the child is cool, calm and pleasant. Once I keep the child down, start. Again, when I carry the child is pleasant, hale hearty and smiling. In the clinic, the child was smiling in front of me. But at home, see the role of the mother. Okay, now this is very interesting. We have a rubric. When the child is placed on the bed, kept on the bed, lied on the bed, the child starts crying. Once I carry her, she's okay. Once I carry her for hours together, she's fine. 24/7 I'm carrying, she's fine. Once I keep her down, child starts crying. We have a rubric. My dear friends, we have a rubric. Everything is given in the repertory. What is the rubric? Just see the rubrics. Just see the beauty of the rubrics. Quieted cannot be. And see this sub rubric. Only by being carried. Can you see the screen?
Yes, it's visible, sir.
Quieted cannot be only by being carried. What does it mean? When the child is being carried continuously, it is quiet. Once the child is not carried and placed on the bed, on the cradle, or anywhere on the ground, the child is not quiet. He has to be lifted it like this continuously. For us together is very difficult. So we have only two remedies in this rubric. Only by being carried. And see the rubric rapidly. What is this rapidly? Okay. Okay. So this is quite it. Only by being carried rapidly. So arsenic and chamomilla. Now how will you differentiate this with chamomilla? Okay, let us see. Chamomilla. First rubric of chamomilla. The essence of and the core of chamomilla is what? What is the core of chamomilla? I'll tell you. What is the core of chamomilla? Write it down, students. Write it down. Snappish. S-N-A-P-P-I-S-H. Snappy. What is snappish? If I'm chamomilla and if you got it? If I'm chamomilla and this is the mother and coming. Remember this gesture. When the physician auscultates or puts the stetho for auscultation to a chamomilla child. If this is a stetho, if this is the stetho, put on the child's chest. Chamomilla will put a frown. This is frown. F-R-O-W-N. Frown. Frown. This is frown. Yeah. If this is the stethoscope, 3 months old child will also just push off the stethoscope just like this. That's it. Because we have a rubric. What is the rubric? Anger touch to vein. Here arsenic is not there. The basic difference of chamomilla. So the essence, the core, okay? The core, the essence, the epicenter of chamomilla is snappish. Frown. That's very abusive, insulting behavior of a child. Chamomilla. Anger touch when chamomilla. But arsenic is not in the rubric. If at all you put the stethoscope on arsenic child's chest, arsenic child will give a good smiling. I will tell you a rubric of arsenic. Smiling. What is smiling? Smiling. Arsenic is there. Chamomilla is not there. The one child who are continuously being carried, once they are placed on the bed or the cradle on the ground, both there are only two kids will cry. And though the cry will be really, really piercing cry, both will cry. Chamomilla will also cry, but arsenic also cry. But arsenic in front of doctors will be a bit better. Arsenic presents himself good, fastidious, smiling. Chamomilla, even to the physician. I don't care, you are a doctor. Just get lost. Chamomila. Okay, you're a doctor. Hello, doctor.
Arsenic.
Difference. Arsenic is in the rubric. What you can say. Rest cannot until things are in proper places. What is this rubric? Rest cannot until... Means what? If a four-month-old infant, you know, he urinates and dirty his clothes, he will start calling the mother. Mommy! Mommy, 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 mommy. Wait. Unless and until the diaper is not changed, this arsenic child will go on just biting her mom. Come, mama, mama, change it. 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 Are, ha, bhai, ha. Then the mother changed and then he is quiet. Only then he can rest. So this is how we understand a remedy. Okay. Now, again, going to the PPT. Again, going to the PPT. I'll tell you. Are you, is it visible, Manish?
Sir, PowerPoint is not visible.
Okay. So this is arsenic. Why it is not?
Sir, now PowerPoint is visible, sir.
Visible, na?
Yes, sir.
Why it is not going down? Somehow it is not coming down. Just a minute. Share screen. Acha. So, arsenic chamomile we already discussed. Okay, now this Sina is also very interesting. This Sina, and we are really short of time. I don't know how will I complete. Forget it. I'll just complete, finish off with Sina and just wind up. Okay. So Sina, because Sina last Kalikarb and Sanikul. I don't know. I'll just go on with the PPTs. Kalikarb, Sina. We have a rubric. Write it down, students. Please. Please write it. Quieted cannot be. Means what? Come what may. Whatever you do. You dance in front of the child. You do what not. You do what not. But still, you are not, you know, quiet. Means what? The patient comes carrying the child in front of you. Okay? And the child is going, quack, 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 quack. You know, since how many hours, last 6 hours, he's just going on crying. Students, note it down, write it down. Last 6 hours, he's just going on crying. And after last 3 hours, he slept. How, I asked him, how did he sleep? He said, he was like, while crying, and crying, there was nothing doing, and he got tired of crying and he slept. Again, when he woke up, again this is going on. So last 4 or 5 hours, he's just going on crying. So how does the child gets, you know, pacified? Patient, the father and the mother said, no doctor, actually when I put on that Chota Bhim cereal, the child always gets, you know, pacified. He just, his attention is diverted. But in spite of Chota Bhim, all musics, all everything is in front, everything, whatever possible ways I have tried to pacify him, this child is just going on crying and shrieking without any result. See the way he's crying. this is the rubric we have. We write it down, my dear friends. And the rubric is quieted cannot be. There's a single sina. See the rubric. Carried desires to be carried constantly, plus rocking amal rate fast, and quieted cannot be. This is the main rubric of sina. The essence of sina. The core, the essence, the epicenter is this. Okay. Chamu will see the frown. Okay. Kalikarp is a big, big story to tell you of Kalikarp. Sanicula hyosamus. ठीक है ठीक है
सर आई थिंक
हेलो
यस सर आई थिंक सर इफ पॉसिबल सर यू कैन कंटिन्यू फॉर अनदर 10 टू 15 मिनट्स सर
इज इट लाइक द ओके सो आई डू वन थिंग
यस सर
पॉसिबल फॉर आई थिंक नो पब्लिक निकल तो नहीं जाएंगे बोर नहीं होंगे बोर होंगे कि नहीं
सर ऑल ऑफ देम आर सेइंग लाइक यू कैन कंटिन्यू सर
Okay. So this is also a child, Kalikarp. Okay. I respect your interest and passion, and I'll definitely carry forward for 10-15 more minutes. Carried desires to be carried constantly. Again, this child also, Kalikarp. Again, this Kalikarp also, child wants to be carried constantly. But, what is the essence of Kalikar? What is the core of Kalikar? What is the center of Kalikar? What is the crux of Kalikar? Is change aversion to me. I'll tell you a rubric. I wanted to go to the repertory now. How? I don't know. Hello. If you understand, Manish, I hope this repertoire is visible.
Yes, sir, it's visible, sir.
If you understand conformism, you will understand Kalikarp. For you, I would like to, tell you the exact meaning of conformism. We have the rubric conformism. What does it mean? Note it down. Write in your notes. Orthodoxy in thoughts and belief. What does it mean? How will you find orthodoxy in thoughts and belief in a 7-month old child? Hello? Change aversion. What does this mean? What does this mean? Change aversion to in Kalikarp. See, this is Kalikarp. Hope you are you can see this Kalikarp in change aversion to. Now you need to understand what is the change of Kalikarp. It's really very interesting, my dear friends. Kalikarp, once she has in this posture, okay? Even the second posture, she doesn't like. She only wants that same posture, the same hand, that same style she should be carried. Okay, number one. This is one. Second, carried means what? Change aversion. Where you'll get change aversion, I'll tell you, my dear friends. I'll tell you, see. Have you ever seen a child? I had a child, I had a case of, I would like to share you that case. A child was absolutely like a vegetable, a cerebral palsy child. Okay. Very bad in state, very, very bad state. The child was not able to sit, not able to hold, not able to see, not able to hear. It was just like a vegetable. But what was the essence? What was the core of the child was every morning. Remember it, understand it really well. This child would sit on her mother's lap only. The same posture. Okay. In the morning, she wants tea and roti, chapati. Tea and chapati. That chapati should be squeezed properly and mash up exactly with the same this consistency into the tea. You have to just, if at all, one sugar means only one sugar. If the sugar is less, she won't eat. If the sugar is more, she won't eat. Same taste. Now, believe me that the child was 4 years, 3 to 4 years old child we bought in front of me. Since her birth, she is only eating this as the breakfast. Anything else than this, she turns her face. She is not ready to change that taste. Can you believe? 6 months, when the child was 6 months of period, 6 months of age, we start, instead of breastfeeding, we start giving outside food. Weaning period, isn't it? So she was not ready to change that mother's milk with full of, you know, hard work from the parents and the guardians and the relatives. She could leave her breastfeeding. And then she started with that nano. Kya bolte usko? Kya kaam karta hai? Bharadi the nano ka the bahar Cerelac. Means whatever, I don't know. Cerelac, I know only Cerelac, I don't know. Then the taste was changed. So she was used to the change. Nanpro, whatever, yes. The taste was changed. Once the taste was changed, she adapted that change for 6 long months. Then dal rice was the food to be given at the age of one. She was not accepting it. Now imagine this crux, the essence, the core, the center of Kalikar con change. She doesn't like change. Kalikar doesn't like change at all. And after giving Kalikar LM potency, she was so changed. She could sit, she could stand, she could walk, she could perceive, she can hear, she can. I've shown this case to so many, you know, seminars, but here in electronic social media, I'm very sorry. But you could feel that confidence after prescribing the Similimum remedy. How does a person change? The conformism. I would like to share you a case of Kalikar of a child, 6th standard child, suffering continuously from asthmatic bronchitis, severe asthmatic bronchitis. So I asked the mother, tell me something characteristic of this child, you know, the main PQRS. She said, this child, my son, is very, very orthodox in nature. Means what? Please focus on that. She said, if at all we go to any picnics, any trips, obviously I don't wear sari, I wear jeans. He says, no, don't wear this. I want you to see in sari only. Can you understand the conformism part, the orthodoxy part of a child? Whenever you go to school, a child, what does a child like to eat? The child likes to eat Maggi. The child likes to eat wafers, chips. The child likes to eat burgers and all those stuffs. And what this Kalikar child would like to eat? this Kalikar child would like to eat roti sabzi, vegetables, rice. Hai na? They are not ready to change. This is a rule. This is a rule. Conformistic in nature. Orthodoxy in thought processes. See, so this is how we understand. But believe me, they want the same thing continuously. This is constantly carried off Kalika. And last and not the least, I'll tell you, wind up Sanicula. Sanicula is a rubric. Carried, deserves to be carried constantly of Sanicula is, write it down. Students, note it down. Sanicula, a remedy for, they always want the mother's breast in their mouth for hours together, for the whole night. The mother will complain, doctor, I really wonder how this child wants my feeding the whole night, continuously. How can I'm also, I know I'm a mother, but how? But how can I stay the whole night awake? The whole day I had to work. The whole day I had to slog in for my in-laws, my husband, my elder child. And this child is not letting me to sleep, not doing anything. Every day, 24/7, this child wants me on the field like this. Is it possible, doctor? I'm really afraid of giving him some medicine. That I don't mind to give him feeding, but what he does, he just sucks for a few time and then just goes on touching the bus, nothing doing through 24/7. Is it possible? This is Sanicula. We have a rubric. Nursing, desires to be nurse all the time. I'll show you the rubric and then I will wind up. We have so many things to do. Shit, man, ये बीच में आ रहा है बराबर. Nurse in children being desired all the time. Aisa rubric hai. Unfortunately, in this repertory, it is only Calcarea Foss. Actually, the second remedy is Sanicula. If you go to Barthel, if you go to Nair's repertory, if you find out complete repertory, write it down. You will find this rubric. Nursing desires to be nursed all the time. Calcarea Foss as well as Sanicula. So, my dear friends, this was a beautiful journey with you all. And I tried my level best to, you know, give so many things together in a small period of 1.5 hours. Actually, 1.5 hours, we cannot learn a single rubric if we had to understand it in full of depth. But I tried my level best to give my level best possible to all my dear friends, students, seniors, juniors, teachers, everyone. And I really thank you all from the bottom of my heart for listening this pep talk, I would say, about homeopathy. And what I would like to advise all the students, start reading Materia Medica. Acha, I would like to tell you one thing. One more last this. See, can you see? Money.
Yes, sir. It's visible, sir.
See, basically, we have. This is not at all my advertisement. Please, my dear friends, don't take it otherwise. This is a book which is around the desk of every single homeopathic doctor who is under HHF and who wants to understand child in its whole extent. This is a book. If you want to, and we have a series of books. So if you want to buy these books, I have written a book of Little Angels. Okay. So Anaka, tumcha number kara. You can just, I will just give you the numbers. We have a series of books. If at all you are interested, please let us know. I'll give you some numbers. You can call them and ask for this numbers, and you can go along. I have described every single child in this book. Okay. These are two numbers. Anaga Mahajan is my wife. You can contact her, or Dr. Poonam Dinde, wife of Dr. Krish Dinde, my friend. You can call them. You can ask. We'll definitely courier it to you. This is not an advertisement. I'm telling you again and again. If you really want to, you know, understand more about homeopathy, please read books. We have some audit separate journals also. We will just post to you. We can definitely follow the path of our orthodox Materia Medicas, Kent, Dr. Kent sir's Materia Medica, Alan Keynote, Boric. Every single book should be, gone. You should go through all those remedies, keynote symptoms of Alan's. Everything is very important, essential for us to grow ahead, to prosper ahead. And the last and not the least, I would like to tell you all. I would like to tell you all that passion is the only source of prosperity. And ultimate say, what I always tell everyone, don't try to follow a goal. And if you feel that you will run around and achieve a goal and then you will feel happy, it is not like that. For that matter, you need to be happy from within. If you are happy and joyful from within, success will follow you, my dear friends. Success will follow. So don't try to follow goals. Try to follow happiness. Try to follow joy. And joy is within. To understand the simulimum. Once you have, our role is to understand the simulimum, and success, prosperity, and everything will follow you. Okay. Saying so, Manish, I am handing over to you.
Yes, sir. Okay, sir. So as sir, we are running out of time, if participants having any doubts, any questions, can they contact you through email, sir?
Of course. And I will see to it. My students, I'll see to it that I'll definitely revert back to your queries. You can just WhatsApp on this number. This is my WhatsApp number. You can ask queries on this number. I'll definitely take time and solve your queries. And for any homeopathy, I'm ready for everything with extended arms. Okay.
Okay, sir. So it was really a wonderful session, sir. So if you permit now, sir, can we bind up the session?
Of course.
Okay. So Hania, you can proceed with vote of thanks. Over to you, Hania.
I, on behalf of Alvis Homeopathic Medical College and Student Council, extend a very hearty thanks to Dr. Mayur Mahajan for gracing your knowledge and time today. A deep sense of gratitude for your explanation on pediatrics. Thank you for being with us this evening. We all had an informative session, so thank you so much. I would also extend my thanks to all the attendees for their involvement and active participation. With this note, we conclude today's session. Bye and good night for today.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you all. Love you all.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.